flag can signify an individual, a small group, or a whole nation. But no matter the purpose or size of the group, all flags have one thing in common. They must be distinct, even from a distance, and, unlike a drawing or painting, need to be recognizable while fluttering in motion. The art and practice of designing flags is known as vexillography. In this lesson, each student will become a vexillologist, designing and creating their very own heraldic flag. It's best to start with a rough sketch or design of the flag before drawing directly onto the fabric. The colors and symbols used should carry personal significance for each student. I am using a blank, unbleached muslin bandana because the edge is already hemmed, so I won't have to worry about loose strings and frayed edges. But really, any thin fabric will do. The bandanas come folded, and if the crease of the fold is persistent, it's really best to give it a quick ironing. I've chosen to use Shiva Richeson paint sticks to draw on the fabric. These sticks are an oil and wax-based solid paint stick. They perform almost like an oil pastel, and are super creamy and go on smoothly. Unlike conventional oil colors, they dry to the touch in 24 hours, have no unpleasant odors or fumes, and they are even non-toxic and hypoallergenic. Now, when they're first opened from the package, there is a protective skin that forms over the surface, and that needs to be removed before using. For younger students, I would suggest removing it with a knife for them to ensure minimal material waste, but they can also be removed easily with scissors. The skin will reform, making them self-sealing and eliminating the need to store them in an airtight container. They come in a variety of colors, as well as larger student-grade color sets. And most importantly, they become permanent on fabric when heat set. Stretch the fabric to ensure it won't pull or wrinkle under the paint stick. To do this, simply place it on top of a piece of cardboard or chipboard and secure with tape on the sides. Be sure to pull the fabric tightly. I could begin by drawing freehand, but I want to show you how rubbing plates can be used for this project. Simply lift the corner of the tape up and slide the rubbing plate underneath in whatever area you want the image to transfer. You can even secure the rubbing plate with a little bit of tape to make sure it doesn't move. Pull the fabric back down, find your image, and begin to rub gently in swirling motions. Start by pressing very lightly. To sharpen the image, you can use a stiff brush, like this bristle brush, to go over the lines. When the composition is finished, heat set by placing a sheet of tracing paper over the image and ironing at the highest setting without steam. To display, each finished piece can be glued to a dowel rod. Place the fabric wrong side up and run a bead of glue along the dowel rod. Stop at the edge of the fabric. Turn the rod to catch the fabric and roll. Embellishments such as pom-poms or embroidery could also be added. Well, I hope you enjoyed this project as much as I have. To find the complete lesson plan PDF and full material list, visit dickblick.com lesson plans. And while you're there, feel free to check out our hundreds of other free lessons and videos.